will you define success?
Success is relative. For some, it is attaining the best or being the best in the field, playing for the world team or the country team or the national team. But for some, it could be that I do what I have set out to do, I attain my goals, I reach where I'm supposed to reach. But for me, I define success as being able to do my 100% into what I want, put my complete passion in it, and day after day go back, be committed, and not worry so much about the end result, but make sure that the commitment and the passion is there throughout. I would define success if I am able to achieve that.
How can we introduce this concept of success and failure to young minds?
I think as teachers and as parents, the pressure on the child to be the best has to be removed. If we are able to impart the importance of the steps that are required to go somewhere or to attain something, and giving importance to doing small things perfectly, doing them with passion, then I think this idea of success will not be dependent on the end result, but will depend on how one approaches this whole thing.
When children experience a low, either in their studies or in their extracurricular, is it a good idea to smile and encourage them, or do we allow them to feel sad and understand the value of failure?
I feel they should understand the value of failure, but also we need to be standing right next to them, having a smile and guiding them to overcome their fears, their lack in anything that they have, and making sure that they do not lose sight of the goal. But somewhere a little bit of fear of failure to a small extent, like the way we have salt in food, that would take, I feel that would take children a long way through.
Most of my friends are no longer my friends because we are competing to come first. What should I do to change this?
Gurudev has this beautiful point in one of our programs for children. Stretch your hand first. So perhaps you could go and speak to your friends, and I'm sure we all understand the importance of having friends and also ensuring that all of us can be successful. You know, in this point of time, I remembered a small story, if that is okay. There was a farmer who was winning the best crop year after year after year. So the reporters came and questioned him, how come you are able to get this? You know, what do you do to ensure that your crops are the best? So the farmer said, I share my seeds with everybody around me. So this baffled the reporter, and he was like, you know, the best thing that is there with you, you're sharing it with everyone. So the farmer said, you know, my crops get pollinated by the insects and birds and butterflies which come from my neighboring farms. So in their success lies my success. So I think this attitude inside us will ensure that we still retain friendships and be successful together. We can walk together.
How you would explain healthy competition?
I would say that competition should be within oneself, and even Gurudev says this time and again. I feel we need to compete with ourselves. Am I better than what I was the last time? If I could run 100 meters in, let's say, 15 seconds, if I can cut it down to 14 and a half seconds, that is where the competition lies. It is about, I think, winning over one's mind and one's thoughts and emotions that bring us down. That, I think, would be healthy competition. And yes, it is also true that this can happen only if we celebrate each other's success.
So as parents and educators, what would the three things be which we should explain to our children about this?
We should first make them aware of the importance of the mind, the emotions, and what am I inside? Because that plays a huge role in ensuring that there is a smile on my face and everybody's face. This is the first thing I would like to share, and I think that can happen only if children are meditating, if children are doing breathing exercises like Sudarshan Kriya, and you know, being helpful, playful. This is what the first thing would be. And I think the second thing that I would like to share is commitment to oneself. If I know this is what I want to do in life, I think we should give them the confidence that they will be able to reach this with, maybe there may be some failures or obstacles in the middle, but then if parents and teachers are there with them, I think they can reach the goal. Giving this confidence is very, very important, along with telling them it's okay to fail. It's okay at the end of the day. If we have done our 100% and yet not got the result that we are looking at or we want, it is okay. Life is bigger than this.
How do the art of living programs for children help them to gain this perspective?
Gurudev has structured these programs in such a beautiful way that all this knowledge comes about in a very playful method, which comes from the children. And what happens then is it becomes a part of the experience. These programs include yoga, meditation, of course they include a special breathing technique, Sudarshan Kriya. There are techniques to excel in anything like the concentration pranayam, and making the child aware that we are a complete personality only when we are able to take everyone with us with a smile, being friendly, being compassionate, doing service, and of course being good in studies, because that is also very, very important.
Now, sometimes despite studying very hard, children don't get admission into the college of their choice, and that can lead them to take drastic steps. How can we make sure that we can maintain the morale of the children and also make sure that they, you know, come out of it with a sportive spirit?
I think from a young age we need to inculcate that it is very important to give our 100%. Now, even after having given 100%, if the child is not getting the college of their choice, it's okay. There are other colleges. There are millions of colleges in this world. It is not as important to one's success that the college is so good as to whether the child or the student can give their 100%. Now, even from small schools, we know from government schools, we have had so many IAS officers coming in. We have had so many sportsmen coming up from such, you know, schools. And that has happened only because the individual is responsible for that change in themselves. And if we are able to show them these examples of people who have come out of their own problems, come out of the issues that they were facing and are able to become something in life, I think that's what we need to do.
So a lot of what you said depends on the communication between parents and children. And the difficulty that parents have as the children grow older especially is that kids will do the opposite of what the parents say. So what would be your advice to manage these situations?
Of course, Gurudev has spoken at length in handling teenagers. But I would say that it is a difficult task, and I'm sure as parents most often need to become friends of our children, and at certain points of time we also have to take up the role of the parent. It is a tightrope that you are walking, but with sensitivity and the love that we have for the child, without crowding our intellect with emotions, if we are able to reach to the child, I am sure children would want to listen to you, because after all, from a very young age, parents are their role models. And if it has changed over a period of years, then you know, we need to make some adjustments or change the way that we are giving this to the kids. And there are two programs of the Art of Living, Know Your Child and Know Your Teen. Perhaps the tips in these programs would help you communicate well with your kids.
The difficulty also comes because at certain times children would have seen that parents withdraw their love unless the child lives up to their parents' expectations. Do you think it's important that parents show their support at times of failure?
It's of paramount importance that parents support kids at all points of time. And yes, I agree to what you said, that the expectations of the parent might be very different from what the child wants in life, be it grades, be it the subjects, be it the career that they are choosing. I think as a parent and as teachers, if we are also supportive of what the child wants and we are willing to have an open mind to have this discussion, I am sure children will make the right choices in life.
Is there a bright side of failure that we should educate children about?
Yes, failure can be the stepping stone for success. Most often, someone who has fallen down needs to learn how to get up. And that is really, really important, be it changing careers, changing the way we function, looking inside ourselves. I think it's very important, and I'm sure all of us agree that if we take the look into the life of any very important person, we see that they have had obstacles, they have faced failures, and that's why they have become so great in their fields. They have understood how to overcome the failures, not just look at it as I am a failure.
So in your experience as a cricketer and as a coach, do you find that there is more learning in success or more learning in failure?
Wow, this is a double-edged sword. Yes, success without humility really doesn't make you learn much. And failure without the conviction that we can win, we can be successful, doesn't help much. I think it's the beautiful combination, being humble, being ready to put oneself out there, being ready to expose myself to all the things and say, I am still all right. Handling emotions, handling our health through breath, you know, having a very calm mind, doing our practices, I think this is very, very important. Mm-hmm.